In today's video, we'll be discussing about the differences and the similarities between medical school in the Philippines and medical school in Ukraine. So if you're an incoming medical student and you're wondering which of these countries best suits you, then this video is for you. Hello lovelies, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Adi and I am an incoming third year medical student currently studying in the beautiful country of Philippines. I create content about medicine, my experiences as a foreign student living and studying in the Philippines. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you guys so much. I am so grateful. And if you're new to this channel, I just hope you find a reason to subscribe to our channel. So our guest today is actually my friend, I would say. He just recently graduated from a university in the Ukraine, and we'll be having him today because he's going to give us more insight about medical education in Ukraine. While me, you know, I'm here in the Philippines, I'm also going to give my own details regarding medical school here in the Philippines. So let's head right into the interview. So our guest today is Dr. Izuchukwu Nwachukwu. And I'll just let you introduce yourself.
Good morning, guys. It's currently 8 a.m. Yeah. We're 5 hours, or you guys are 5 hours ahead of us in the Philippines. So I think you guys are around 1 p.m. right now. I just graduated medical school this year as a medical doctor. And I'm currently still in Ukraine. Zaporizhia, Ukraine, where I graduated from.
What's the name of your school? The name of your school?
No, my school is Zaporizhia State Medical University, Zaporizhia, Ukraine.
Okay.
It's located at one of the eastern states in Ukraine.
Okay. All right. So, you know, like you guys, I've known... I'll be addressing you as Dr. Izu now because levels have changed. So I've known him for a while now. I think 4 years, right? From Abuja.
Around 4 years.
Yeah. So when I was planning on coming to medical school, I did ask him about medical school in Ukraine, you know. So I just want to know, because I know from the top of my head, right, I know about five of my friends that have graduated from Ukraine, and it left me wondering, like, how are there so many Nigerians in Ukraine studying medicine?
There are a lot of Nigerians in Ukraine studying medicine at the moment, and not only medicine, there are also other courses that people study here too. There's engineering, there's economics, there's law, there's aviation, there's nursing, and so much more. Actually, not only Nigerians, there's also a lot of Indians are here too. A lot of students from Arabic nations, a lot of students from Morocco, they're also here. So I think one factor people really consider when coming here is how affordable the tuition is as compared to a lot of other countries.
Okay, so like on the average, like how much are we looking at? Like on the average for tuition?
Okay, when it comes to medicine, for first year, you're spending averagely $7,000. And that would include the tuition, the processing of your documents, your accommodation for a full year, your temporary residency, and all those documentations. Then upwards from second year, medicine is a CCA course here. So from second year to your sixth year, you're spending roughly around $4,500.
Wow. It's kind of affordable. So that's why we have like lots of foreign students coming to the Ukraine.
Absolutely.
And you also mentioned about 6 years, because here in the Philippines, med school here is 4 years, in the sense that you should have done a first degree before you can, you know, apply to the proper med school. So you're saying that in Ukraine, it's basically 6 years.
Yeah, 6 years or true. It's a 6 years program.
Okay, so how about people that already have a first degree? Because in my case, remember I mentioned to you that I have a first degree. So, for people who ha already have a first degree, how many years are you expected to do in med school? Are you expected to still do the 6 years, or like how does it work?
I think people that have a first degree still have to do the 6 years. And the reason for that is
What?
simply because funny enough. I think the reason for that is because medicine differs from country to country, from region to region. For example, now you go back to Nigeria, Africa, and you're dealing with malaria. Right, and then you're here in Ukraine, it's not an issue for them, so they don't focus on malaria as a subject topic as much as they focus on COPD, for example, something that really affects their community, that affects the nation. So it differs from medicine differs from region to region, from country to country, according to the specifics of what they are dealing with. And with that, also the teaching format also differs. So you don't want that maybe you come in with a degree and maybe you have to join in your second year, for example, and then there are lots of thoughts, there are lots of subjects they already taught in first year, which you don't know about because of the difference in curriculum from where you're coming from.
Wow. So
However,
there's nothing like evaluation, like
no, but there
evaluating
is.
documents.
There is. I've heard of people transfer from China. I've heard of people transfer from Nigeria. I think there are certain schools that let you do the transfer. So I think
Okay.
there is.
Okay. So how about the requirements for studying medicine in Ukraine? For Philippines, I know that if you need your WAEC for the requirements for Philippines, you need your WAEC certificate. Like you should have passed your WAEC or maybe your NECO and then your national international passport. I think that's the basic thing for medical school. So in Ukraine, what are the requirements? What are the requirements for medical school in
Think
Ukraine?
you just write about the same. So we need your WAEC results. Or
Okay.
I think your GCE. I'm not so sure about GCE, but WAEC results, your international passport, and I think your birth certificate. But the documents needed are easily accessible, so it's not there's no IELTS needed. There's no jam or some yeah something.
Obviously, we are running away from JAMB.
Yeah.
Anyways, in case you guys don't know what JAMB means, JAMB is the exam we take after high school to, get admission for Nigerian universities. So, how about English? Do you guys, you mentioned there is no English proficiency examination for Ukraine. So, are you guys being taught in English?
Absolutely, we've been taught in English, and well at that, we'll have for my school, we have up to 3 years. You study Russian as a language, which is now which they've changed to Ukrainian, which is what they really speak in most part of Ukraine. But as of when I still had language, because I studied Russian, so I'm more of a
How many years did
certified.
you study
I
that?
studied Russian for 3 years.
3 years?
Yeah,
Is
it's
it
like,
inclusive of your medical
yeah,
school?
it's inclusive. It's like a course on its own, like studying anatomy. This is like a course on its own. Yeah.
Okay.
So I
Okay.
graduated, or I finished studying Russian in my 3rd year, and I'm proficient in the language. But however, they
Oh,
do,
wow.
yeah. So, but they do speak, they do teach in English.
In English.
Yeah.
So, like, because I think I made one in my research online some time ago, and I found out that there are some schools they will say if you want to attend a school that speaks English, you would pay higher. And if you want to attend a school that speaks maybe in Russia or teaches in Russia, you pay lesser. Is it the same case in Ukraine?
It is. English students tend to pay more. Well, I think is just maybe a bit reasonable in the sense that okay, this is not an English speaking country.
Country, yeah.
Yeah, and having these teachers to learn English Some of them at very old age, just to be able to communicate with you, I think is what's the difference, or is what the amount that you pay. And compared to the fact that what you pay is not even much, it's not even so much compared to what other European countries or other countries that offer medicine, other countries require. So I think it's okay.
Okay, for you Philippines, comparing that to Philippines, you're not expected to do like any additional language course. Like once you get admission, you're being admitted to the proper med school. You don't even need to do any language course, maybe Tagalog or the local language here, because we are also being taught in English. And this brings me to my next question. How about the cost of living in Ukraine? Like, what's the cost of living like based on like maybe the rent, light, electricity, and internet? How what's basically the average students can spend?
Okay, I think that's really a bit relative, depending on your taste, and all of that distance, and there are just some other normal factors. For example, staying at the center of the city may mean that you may pay more as compared to staying towards the outskirts. Sometimes it's a different city, bigger cities or the capital city, for example, the rent is usually higher. And most students here stay in the hostel, and that is very, very cheap.
So in
Maybe
Ukraine, they
around,
provide hostels, accommodation for students. Oh, really?
they do. Yeah, they do, and you pay yearly.
Like
And others
on
prefer
the average, how much is the accommodation for hostel? Do you have an
accommodation
idea?
for hostel to be around $500 on an average
Per
for
month, a
a
year.
year.
Oh,
Yeah.
okay. So that's
So that
about 50, less than $50 per month, basically.
yeah. And you just pay the whole year, and that's just it.
Okay.
But then there are also restrictions in the hostel, like especially if it's the school hostel, then there are restrictions. Like there should be a time where you shouldn't go out, like after 11 p.m. So you can't move out. You usually have a shared room with someone, and sometimes it's not just what you want. So people
Okay.
opt to just move out so they can have their freedom to do, to live their lives basically.
So how
So
much like
rent
cheap, yeah,
money,
in those kind of
yeah.
apartments, how much is the rent?
Rent in my city is relatively cheap as compared to a place like Kyiv, which is the capital city of Ukraine, or Kharkov, which was the former capital city, or other cities like that, other bigger cities. So rent here may be averagely maybe 300, 400, $500 a month as compared to as compared
Per month.
to in Australia.
That's okay, but I think that's a bit high because comparing that to Philippines, I don't know about other cities though, but in the city I live, I study and live in Cebu City, and I think rents ranges from between 5,000 peso to 12,000 peso. In conversion to dollar, that's about roughly between $100 to $240 per month. Do you guys pay per month or yearly?
That's cheap. We pay per month.
Wow. I think when it comes to accommodation, maybe Philippines is a bit more cheaper. What do you think?
But then again, you can always find like let's it depends on your preferences
Yeah.
basically. If you like the taste of luxury, or if you just like a very cozy apartment, or you just want to study, you don't mind where you stay,
Yeah.
then you can definitely get a place for $100 actually. Yeah, you can get a place for 200. You can get a very good place for $200 close to the city, but if you're in that range,
Okay.
and then you pay monthly.
How about the utility bills? Are they inclusive of the rents or they are separate?
No, they are usually separate
Okay.
from the rent.
Okay. Another important question I would like to ask you is about the board exams. So when you guys graduate, are you guys given the opportunity to write the Ukrainian board exams, basically?
So there are about three or four steps in the Ukrainian board exams. There's a step one. In the language, it's called crook. So we call it crook one, crook two. Step one is usually in your 3rd year. So after that, you'll be able to progress to 4th year and continue. So
Okay.
first one, you have around 3 chances to write it within that period. So you should normally written towards the ending of June, and the results are usually out in 2 weeks. If a student doesn't pass, for example, a person has to rewrite in, say, July, and then if he still doesn't pass, he has to rewrite again in August. And if he still doesn't pass, then he has to repeat his 3rd year again.
Wow.
And
So are foreign students given this opportunity to write these crook exams?
you cannot progress without writing them. And even up to your 6th year, you have the crook term, and that's usually written only once. So
So
if students
right
write,
now you have your crook one and two?
in
Wow.
1 system,
Okay, wow.
yeah,
So
so
how does it work? So after graduation, do people want to stay back to continue the rest of the steps of the examination?
yeah, that is the really touchy part about staying back in Ukraine, is that you're not given the opportunity to practice medicine as in practice. You may be able to learn, but not practice. And maybe they are still developing or working on that. But I think one of the reasons is because you are not a citizen. So in order to be able to have to step up to the one of the criteria writing the step three is that you have done the 1 year internship.
Okay.
Or thereabouts,
And the
and
internship is done after graduation, right?
it's not a graduation.
Okay.
There's one you do in 6th year, which is also included in your medical school, but that's just the school's part, those stuff. But there's the real one, which is right done like after graduation, if I'm being correct. And the thing is, it's usually the Ukrainians or their citizens, or those that have permanent residency in Ukraine that
Write the
can really,
exam.
really work. Yeah, the 3rd step, that can really, really write the exam and work as a doctor in Ukraine. So what usually happens is that those who decide to stay back would usually have to, they normally would have to extend their stay. And
Okay.
they do this through applying for postgraduate studies.
Okay.
So postgraduate studies, they also pay tuition fee, and
Yeah.
they are being taught and everything. So,
Okay,
but then you're
so
not really getting the practical out of medicine at that time, because there are a lot of things they consider if you are really, really going to be working as a doctor and
yeah.
working with the patients, and they are trying to entrust the patients into your hands. Is such a huge step for people, and that's where the language comes into play, really. So even as much as you've been taught in English, but what about interacting with patients that don't even care about you and whatever English you speak, right? They just want to get treated. How will you interact with them? So that's why the language is important in the first place. And most people, there's they don't make use of the opportunity to learn the language. So they are not very proficient in speaking Russian or Ukrainian, and that means they cannot really, really help patients. So the best they can do is just to sit down and be mentored by a doctor, which, in other words, is usually what happens in the postgraduate period.
Okay, so I think the first factor is for practicing is that foreign students are really not given that opportunity, and also you need to have like a permanent residence or something before you can actually be admitted to practice. And then you also
So
mentioned language, which is also a very
language.
important factor. And I think, well, in Philippines actually, I think there are also other like there are steps if you want to practice here in Philippines as a foreigner, but I really don't know anyone at this point that has graduated, like a Nigerian that has graduated here in the Philippines and was able to write the board exams. The only person I know that did the 1 year
housemanship after graduation, she still was not able to write the exam because they required some documents that she was not able to provide. So literally, she has gone back to Nigeria, and at least she has written the Nigerian board exams and she has passed. So I think this is something people need to have at the back of their minds, because I've met people that say that they didn't really know that, you know, studying in Philippines, that they will not be able to write the board exam. So, but I think it's still fair enough though. Even though it
Yeah, but
can, yeah, it's really a challenge,
it's
right?
yeah, it is, and I think it's like that for some countries. But other countries happen to you writing exams, but other countries happen to you coming from a whole different region, a whole different style of medicine. As long as you pass board exams, you can start up like US, Canada, UK, other EU countries, Germany, France, Monaco, Australia. They are usually open to postgraduate
Foreigners.
studies and yeah, and working as resident doctors.
But the good thing about studying in Philippines and Ukraine that I would say is regarding the tuition, it's really, really affordable when you compare it to these
It is
countries we just mentioned earlier.
affordable,
So
yeah, absolutely.
if you're on a budget, I would suggest you come to these countries. But if you have the money for US,
Absolutely,
Canada, by all
why not?
means, right? And then this
Yeah.
brings me to my next question. How is racism as a black man or a black guy in Ukraine? Have you experienced racism? Is there racism in Ukraine?
I think when it comes to racism, it's such a relative term. I don't think there's especially nowhere, no country in the world where people have not experienced racism. I think even Nigerians in Nigeria still experience racism from the white folks there. I mean, it happens anywhere and everywhere. But in Ukraine, I think it's relatively low as compared to maybe different places. We don't hear a lot of news about maybe blacks being killed or something by Ukrainians. Most people that have had such incidences of, or most people that died, they are usually maybe they went for swimming and they didn't know how to swim and they drowned and all of those things. But there are usually one or two cases once in a while where someone was harassed, someone was assaulted, and maybe just tear up the public for a while and everything. But I think the Ukrainians are a bit open. Well, once again, it depends on. Depends on the clique of it. I would just say that it depends on the clique of it. It depends on the kind of person you are too. And sometimes people just have a whole different issue than racism. Like I remember one time I was in a different city and I drove down to the train station to pick a friend. So I entered back into the car to drive back and then someone just pointed a gun at my head. He just came down from his camp and got my head, and I think I can't remember if he was drunk and everything. I'm pretty sure he was not sitting to observe if I was black or white or brown or blue or anything. He just pointed a gun at my head. So I didn't see that as racism, not because it can be, but I think he just had a lot of other issues going on in his mind and all of that. So, well, the thing is, racism is everywhere. We just say that outright. Racism is everywhere. We experience it in different ways, but maybe they may just say things. Maybe it's their teenagers who just use the N-word because they just heard it. They just want to use it and all of that. And
All right, how about the relationship of the locals, that's the Ukrainians, with foreign students? How is the relationship? Are they open to foreign students?
Again, it's kind of relative, but I think it's on a personal level. I think most people are open, in my opinion and in my experience, most people are open to having foreigners in their city. Others think foreigners want to come and take over their country, and they are very hostile to them. So I think it's personal. It depends on who,
On an
and that's why I say,
individual, so it's not
yeah.
generalized.
Yeah, it's not generalized, and that's why I say the clique you keep, the set of Ukrainian friends you have would usually matter. If there are people that are open to having you around, and they are
Yeah.
really one of the sweetest people, actually, they'll help you
Oh.
explore. Yeah, they'll help you explore their city, their nation. Tell you the cheapest places to get things done, and even the fun places you don't even know. And
I think that's also like comparing that to Philippines, I think that's basically like the way I think the relationship is basically personal. There are people, just the way we have good and bad people everywhere, there are also good and bad people. But I feel, in my own personal experience though, I feel Filipinos are open to foreign students. But again, it depends on the individual. There are people like try to separate themselves, and there are also people that are very, very friendly to foreign students. So I think it has to do more like on an individual level. Yeah. Anyways, so what's your plan going forward? What's your plan basically? What's your next plan, your medical plan? Yeah.
So I really do want to practice medicine. I didn't just study medicine just to get a degree and move on with life.
Obviously.
I know that, like, a lot of people do that actually, and that is not bad. If you have the money to, live your life, why not? But then the fact that you can just know family that ability to practice and just only to study and keep studying and studying was just so. I think I'll have to go back to Nigeria and then write the board
What exam?
exams. Yeah, do the internship, the house job, and then no matter which one they are. Although I don't plan on staying in Nigeria for that long, but I think in the long term, no matter where I eventually go to for residency, I will still come back to my own country. So I just see it twice that I get my license to practice in my country, so that no matter where I go, I can still be able to come back and still work in my country. So
That's
right now
cool.
the plan is just to go to Nigeria, pass
Nigeria.
the board exams, and then from there do my house job, and then life will just because.
I think that's also the situation here, as in most foreign students, especially Nigerians though, once they graduate, most of them go back to Nigeria to write the board exams, because like I said, I don't know anyone that has been able to write Filipino board exams. That's basically how it also works here. Anyways, so to wrap up this interview, what's your advice to future incoming medical students?
Okay, everyone talks about study, study, study at their country. It's not such nice
Obviously.
to mention, like, medical school, you will study, your life be a mess.
What's your
You
advice?
wouldn't study actually. But while at it, you would also forget things. So don't feel bad that you forget certain things and everything and all of that. And don't just aim for marks. I think that's one thing I'll say. Don't just aim for marks, because medicine is really different from other courses, and there's a reason why you deal with lives
Yeah.
in that particular time. It's like someone comes to you all bad, or maybe in an emergency, and then you do one thing, you do a step of things, and then person's life is prolonged for another 20 years, something like that. So there's a lot of gratification that comes from, I've done something good today. And
Yeah.
medicine is a whole, medicine is like a horror movie to be frank, because you just see people just die for no reason. And sometimes, like, I remember when we were studying gynecology and obstetrics, and I was studying about, is this the normal birth process that most of us came into the world through? Like, I was so confused that I was like, it's not that I was confused about the topic, but like, women are trying. And then I was like, okay, I'm not going to get married, because I don't want anybody to pass through this stress. Right? Like, you just get to that point where you are being so real with the whole thing. But one advice I always give is try to explore and enjoy life. Really, don't get so locked up in the process that you don't have other things that you are doing. Don't let your life be so. It's a good thing to let your life be centered around medicine, but constantly try to
explore.
explore,
Yeah.
relearn, unlearn certain things, learn new stuff. Don't just
Absolutely.
be in a particular city and graduate without learning the language, without making new friends. Not just Nigerian friends or friends from your own country, but the locals, other countries, other international students. Explore,
Yeah.
try different cities. If you have the opportunity to travel to different countries, explore.
So basically what you're trying to say, people should try and explore and, you know, live life basically, not just passing through med school.
Yeah, let med school pass through you. Just live life. You don't have to have everything figured out. You don't have to keep worrying about the next step.
Yeah.
Just sometimes just take a break and just rest. Like you've tried. It's not easy getting to this point.
All right. Thank you so much, Dr. Izu. Like levels have changed. This is real doctor, the hottest and the newest doctor.
Thank you so much
for your time.
So if you watch to this point, thank you so much. I hope this video has been able to give you more insight into medical education in the Philippines and Ukraine. And I hope it will help you to make a better decision towards your medical education. And if you have not subscribed yet, can you consider subscribing now? Till I see you in my next video. Bye-bye.